Welcome dear students to another class of computer. So in previous class we were discussing chapter number 5 Excel. Okay, so in that previous video we have seen how to change the width and height of a column and row. Okay, so I am just going to tell you about these options that you can see here, row height and these things in practically. So just click on this format tab. It is present on home. Okay, home. And in home you will find cells as a group, and in cells group format tab, just click on that. So here it is given row height. Row height is used to increase or decrease the height of a row. That you can do from here also, as well as just click on this cell and then just drag and drop. Okay, so it will increase or decrease the height of a row. Second is auto fit row height. This option is used to automatically fit the row height as per the content given in the cells. These are the cells. This is one cell, this is second cell, okay, like this. Okay, so this is auto fit row height. Third option is column width. So these are the columns A, B, C, D. So we can increase or decrease its width by dragging and dropping this arrow. This black color symbol, you just drag it, it will increase the size. You just drag it back, then it will decrease its size. Okay, taking it towards right hand side, it will increase the width, and taking it towards the left side, it will decrease the width. Okay, like that you can increase or decrease the width of a column. Auto fit column width means automatically it will fit the column width according to the content. Okay, default width means the width that is already available in the spreadsheet when we open it. So see here, this is sheet 1. So these are the default width. Okay, we have not changed it, so this is the default width. Okay, next option given here is this hide and unhide, that we have already seen. Renaming of sheet, we can change the name of a sheet, like here it is data of students. Okay, so and move and copy, tab color, these three protection, these are of no use right now, so we are skipping it. Okay, so see here, we can specify the column width from the range. Minimum is 0 and maximum is 255. Okay, and if you are providing 0 as a range row value, then it will be hidden. Okay, so always columns height is measured in characters and row height is measured in points. So 1 point is equal to 0.035 centimeter. So the default width of a column is 8.43 characters, and that of row is 12.75. okay, so these are the default width or height of row and column. Okay, now you can select a column to a specific width. For that you have to go in home tab, and then from format tab you can do that. Okay, so next topic we are going to discuss is how we can find and select a data range in a given range. Okay, so see here, I have written some data. So by default, whenever you are writing some data, it will appear. See here, I am writing something on this row. I am writing name. Okay, so name, it will always align in the left hand side. All text align in the left hand side. And if I am writing some number, it automatically align in the right hand side. So these text, they are already aligned in the left hand side by default automatically, but I have arranged them in center with this option. Okay, by default it is like this whenever you are typing. Okay, and if you want to change its alignment, just select the range and give it a alignment center. Okay, like this. So if I want to add some more data, I am writing John, and its percentage I am writing 78. Like this you can enter the data. Here I am writing Khushi, and percentage I am writing 79. Like this you can also enter the data. For deletion, select the cell and press delete key, selection and delete key. So I have inserted these data in this spreadsheet. Okay, now what I am doing is, see here, filtering function. Okay, so for filtering data, we have two, it is available in two places. One is home and another is data. So in home you will find this funnel symbol. Okay, so just click on here and click on filter. So this arrow, small triangular arrow, is known as filter. Okay, so with filter, filter cells are based on certain criteria or condition. So see here, we can, if we will apply on this, clicking on this, there is text filter. So text filter means we can select particular text from this. So if I want to select these two, just click on it, then it will show you that particular thing. If you want to remove, select all and click on OK. So it will show you back the data. Similarly, click on percentage. There is numerical filter. So you can filter numerically, like greater than or equal to, provide any range here. So I am writing 58 and click on OK. So see, it is showing the data that is equal to 58 or greater than 58. If you want to remove the filter, click on select all and OK. So like this, we can remove the filter. Okay, so this is this data. Highlight the column in which you want to apply filter. Click on data tab. So here also you will find filter. Go on data tab, you will find this filter. Though this is filter, if you will click on this, it will disappear. If you will click, it will appear. Okay, so click on triangular boxes. These are the triangular boxes. Okay, choose the filter, numeric, custom filter, and then click on okay. So like this, you can see the result. Okay, next topic is finding cells based on certain criteria with conditional formatting. Conditional formatting, as the name suggests, it just depicts the particular values on the basis of condition. So that you will find on home tab, and click, go to the styles. So see here, so let's see how we can apply the conditional formatting. Just go on this conditional formatting option. Okay, so select the data. Suppose I want to apply formatting on these cells. So select that, go on conditional formatting, right? Choose the condition that you want greater cells that are like 76, more than 76, greater than 76. If you want to change the color, just click here, change any color, green. Okay, so see those values which are greater than that, it is shown with this green colors. Okay, so like this you can apply the conditional formatting. Okay, so see here in your book what is given, just see that. Click on home tab in the ribbon, click on conditional formatting under the style group. There is another way, I am just showing you that, I am just control z it so that it will be in previous stage. Okay, now another way is go to conditional formatting, click on new rules. Okay, and here just select the second option, format only cells that contain. Give a range here, 50 to 60. Okay, and then click on this format tab. It is just taking some time. Then go on fill tab. There is fill option. Choose any color that you want to fill. Click OK and OK. That is not applied because we have not selected this thing. Okay, just select it. Go on conditional formatting, new rules. Give value, second option, give value 50 to 60, go on format, pick a color, click on OK, OK. So see, 50 to 60 we have given the range, so this is the values, okay, and they are shown with the color thing. So like this you can apply conditional formatting, okay, these are the options given in your book. So like that you can also apply. So see here, it is also given 3. My values are different from this value, so it is just shown at two places. It is value greater than 60. Okay, now view menu. View menu shows the lines like grid line. Grid lines means these lines that you are finding on the spreadsheet, all these things that you are checking, and small lines, these lines, they are known as grid lines. So they are faint lines that appear around the cell, and they are used